everyone. Welcome to People's Online. Our goal is to inspire you and encourage you in your walk of faith. We welcome you to join us on Sundays at 9:30 and 11:15 a.m. Stay tuned right to the end of the video. We'll have some ways for you to connect with us. Thanks for watching today's message.
Well, today, if you haven't noticed, PC Kids is taking over. We are hijacking the service, and we have all sorts of wonderful performances for you. And so first, I'd like to welcome our preschool class with Miss Becky. Don't know, during the week, the church here is actually also filled with children. Our Little People's Daycare is one of the best rated daycares in Hamilton, and we are so excited to have room 8 or half of room 8 come on up, and they're going to be also singing and performing for us today. Would you please join me in giving them a warm round of applause?
joy to the world, the Savior's born. Let heaven and nature sing. Let men their songs employ. All hail to the newborn King. Yup, good news for the human race that Jesus came to take our place. What? The Lord has come. Let's rejoice. Let's lift our hands and our voice. Come on, everyone, joy, 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 joy.
Wednesdays classes. So every week throughout the school year, we run a program called PC Kids Wednesdays where we offer classes to kids. They get to come learn new skills, make new friends, have tons of fun. And for the past 2 months, our classes have been learning all sorts of new things to perform for you today. So I'd like to introduce our PC Kids Wednesdays ribbon dancing class.
God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, so that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life.
Did you know that your baby child, you're holy, is the great.
Thank you, Ribbon Dancing Class. That was just beautiful. Next up, we have another one of our PC Kids Wednesdays classes, and this is our PC Kids Wednesdays acting class. So they've been working very hard, and they have a play for you, and what they're going to do is they're going to tell you the Christmas story in a way that maybe you've never heard it before. So would you please give a warm welcome to our PC Kids acting class.
Ladies and gentlemen, we welcome you to Larry Prince Live.
Hi! I'm Larry Prince, and this is Larry Prince Live. Thank you. I'm beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Well, and speaking of which, I think they put up the wrong furniture. How am I supposed to sit in that? Well, anyways. We'll see what we can do. Anyways, speaking of Christmas, we're gonna tell you the story today of Christmas in a four-part series, the original Christmas. Now, I know you've probably read about it in Matthew and Luke, but we wanted to bring it to you from the perspective of people who were actually there. Unfortunately, none of them would come and talk to me, I don't know, something about their reputation. So we got the next best thing. We got some of the animals who were there. That's right, we're gonna be talking to animals today. And our first guest today is Donna the Donkey. Oh, you wanna sit down, okay. Hang on. Okay.
Thanks, Gary.
It's Larry.
It is?
Yes, it is. Now, Donna, do you remember meeting the baby Jesus?
Oh, that little cutie. He was a little cutie, Larry. He had the cutest little dimple.
You saw the baby Jesus?
Saw him. I carried him all the way to Bethlehem.
What? I thought he was born in Bethlehem.
He was, but who did you think carried his mother grave with a child across the desert?
Was that you?
Well, it wasn't a jackrabbit.
Well, I didn't think it was.
I can't imagine a jackrabbit carrying a pregnant lady.
Neither can I.
She'd say, you mind if I hop on? He'd say, you mind if I hop away screaming?
Yeah, I guess so. Now, when did you realize that the baby Jesus was someone special?
I knew Jesus was special. I knew Jesus was special before he was even born.
Really? How?
Because of his mother and father, they couldn't stop talking about him. Now, mind you, most parents are like that even if their child is a goober.
Tell me about it.
But not all parents find out their babies from an angel. An angel went to Mary and said, you're going to have a baby, and went to Joseph and said, all that stuff Mary told you about is true.
Well, that's quite the story.
Tell me about it. I was stopping off for a drink of water when I first heard it. I was so stunned, I did a spit take.
Ew, really?
Water shot out of my nostrils. It was kind of embarrassing.
And gross. Now, did you realize that the baby Jesus was someone, a gift from God, after hearing about the angels?
Well, I was a little skeptical at first. Most time you hear men talk about seeing angels, they turn out to be a little nuts. But then the baby was born and some shepherds comes and some wise guys.
Well, you mean some wise men?
I don't know how wise they were. They brought gold and spices to a newborn baby. You know what a baby needs?
What's that?
Diapers.
I guess so. But you saw all these things.
Yes, and when I saw them, I believed this was no regular baby. And did he have a cute dimple?
Yes, well, thank you for being with us, Donna. It's great telling your story. I gotta get up. Okay. All right. Okay, well, our next two guests were actually in the stable when the baby Jesus was born. They were actually born in Bethlehem themselves. Please welcome Clara and Caitlin Cow.
Thank you for having us, Barry.
It's Larry.
It is?
It is. And now, Claire, I understand you were actually in the stable when the baby Jesus was born.
Oh, what a little angel face. He was so cute. He had a little dimple.
You remember the baby Jesus being born?
I'll never forget.
Well, you two must have been thrilled.
Absolutely not.
What? But it was a special time.
We were not all thrilled. It was having a bunch of people in our house that night. Woof.
But it was very...
All day long, Greg the goat kept saying, they didn't sit long up. They're running out of room. And I kept saying, no way there's some people are here. Stables are for animals, not people. But what do you think happens around bedtime?
People in the stable?
A man, a donkey, and a pregnant woman who immediately goes into labor.
She went into labor right away?
As ready as she was, I'm surprised she made it to Bethlehem.
But she did have the baby in the stable.
Oh, yes, and it's very hard to sleep when someone is giving birth.
I guess so.
A cow has to have her sleep, Barry.
It's Larry.
Oh, but when the baby was born, you just knew he was special.
You knew right away?
Well, the star and the shepherd kind of clued us in. But yes, the whole stable just felt different because of his presence.
Well, I guess that made everything okay then, huh?
Well, I'm still mad at that innkeeper.
Really? What for?
Well, you don't put a baby in a stable, especially if it's the son of God.
Well, I guess that's a good point.
So the innkeeper was in any milk for a few days.
No milk? Uh-oh.
Oh, and boy, were his customers mad when they didn't have any milk for their frosted flakes.
Frosted flakes? Who ever heard of frosted flakes in ancient Bethlehem?
Who ever heard of a talking cow?
Good point. Well, thank you, Clara and Caitlin, for being with us here today.
Oh, that dimple.
I don't know how they get up so quickly, but all right then. Okay, so our next two guests were not actually in the stable when the baby was born, but they were there when a special invitation was given to see the baby Jesus. Please welcome Sally and Sarah Sheep. Oh, almost missed it.
Wee doggies, thanks for having us, Jerry.
It's Larry. Larry Prince? Don't you know me from TV?
Shucks, no, Jerry, I'm a sheep. We don't go to no TV in the green pastures. You know the one beside the still waters?
Now, is that beside near the Valley of the Shadow of Death?
No, it's near Bethlehem.
That's right, we were in the field when the angel came to share the good news of Jesus with the shepherds.
Wow, now what was it like seeing them angels appear in the sky?
Oh, Jerry, it was pretty, so pretty. The angels came out of nowhere with their halos and their wings and instruments. What do they call them things?
You mean harps?
They commenced singing glory to God in the highest and peace on earth. It was the most glorious singing we ever heard.
Wow, what did the angels, what did the shepherds do?
Oh, golly, Larry, they were scared. They were just sore afraid.
Sore afraid?
That's right, sore afraid. One of them quaking in his boots and another one hiding his eyes.
One of them thought the angel had come to take him to glory. He grabbed his shirt and yelled out, I'm coming, Elizabeth.
Poor fella.
Nah, but they was real happy when they calmed down and heard what yon angel had to say. They was all, y'all should go see this thing, what has happened in Bethlehem. And they was all, yeah, we should go see this thing, what the angel had sang about.
Wow, now did you get to go with them?
Of course we did. We had to see this thing for ourselves, Jerry.
Do you remember anything they said?
Well, he was tiny and he was sleeping in the hay inside the manger. And he had the cutest little dimple.
Afterwards, they headed back, praising God and telling all of us about the baby.
Wow, that's amazing.
You know, Jerry, it always seemed kind of odd to me why the good Lord would invite a bunch of smelly shepherds to see his newborn son. But then I think God was just being naive. He sent everybody, so he wanted to make sure everybody knew they was welcome.
Wow, that's a beautiful message to end this beautiful interview.
And a smelly one. I mean it, Jerry. Them boys never bath.
Yes, well, thank you, Sally and Sarah Sheep, for being with us here today. I got this. Okay. Now, our next two visitors, our next two guests, actually traveled a very long distance to see the baby Jesus, but I think we can all agree that was a very wise decision. Please welcome Cora and Cody Camel.
Our pleasure, Larry.
You know my name?
Of course I do, Larry. Boy, you're a fine talk show host, and I love your great work.
Yes. Well, of course. Now, okay. You know, you are the first animal to get my name right.
Well, I guess you pick up a few things hanging out with wise men.
I guess so.
That's how he came to meet the baby Jesus. You know, our master spotted his star in the sky and we set off on a long journey west.
Now, did you know you were going to see someone special?
Of course we did, Larry. You don't call them wise men just for being good Monopoly players, you know.
I guess not.
Our masters had read the ancient prophecies of the Israelites, telling of the time and the way of when the baby Jesus would be born. When they spotted the star in the sky, they knew they just had to have one look for themselves.
So you followed the star and it led you to Bethlehem.
No, dear boy, it led us to Jerusalem. That's where the king is, you know. And he was quite puzzled when we asked him about the newborn king. But luckily, he had some fairly wise fellows of his own, and they opened the book of Micah to say you'll find him in Bethlehem.
Well, how wise of you to ask for directions.
Well, just because you're wise doesn't mean you have all the answers, but it means being smart enough to ask for directions.
Right. Well, so you actually went to Bethlehem and saw the baby Jesus.
Oh, what a cute little pumpkin head.
I heard that.
He had the cutest dimple.
Heard that too.
Our master brought him gold, a spice called frankincense, and an oil called myrrh. These were items fit for a king, so it was rather strange seeing them in such poor hands.
Well, they must have been overwhelmed.
They were, but not as much as our masters. You see, this baby boy was the Son of God. He was the Redeemer of the world. We'd bring something far more better than gold or frankincense or more. He would bring eternal life.
How true.
I still get people today asking me about our journey. How long did it take? What did the star look like? How much gold did you bring? I tell them none of that really matters. The true major in the story is the story of Christmas.
Well, those are very wise words from a very wise camel.
Thank you, Larry.
Well, thank you, Cora and Cody.
Our pleasure.
Okay. All right, well, that's the story as we know it now from the perspective of the animals who were actually there. We want to thank you. That's all the time we have for today. Good day and Merry Christmas.
We have our PC Kids Wednesdays choir class. Would you please give them a warm welcome? Beautiful. Thank you, PC Kids Choir. All right, next up we have joining us all of the kindergarten to grade fives who are here on a Sunday morning. So whether you realize it or not, sometimes when you're down here in church, we've got a whole wing upstairs that is just full of kids. And we're so excited. They've been practicing lots, and we're excited to have them come on up here. All right, would you please give a warm round of applause to our Sunday morning kindergarten to grade five class.
Calling, but in this world of sin,
they just do a wonderful job. Let's give one more round of applause. We so hope you enjoyed our performances today. The kids have been working so hard, and we really hope you enjoyed it. We also just want to let you know that after the service, we have more fun for your family. So if you haven't had a chance yet, please check out our live nativity, which is out front. You can go ahead and pet the animals. There's hot chocolate, apple cider. We also have a family photo booth, so you can go get your picture taken and take it home with you today. Now I'd like to ask Pastor Tony to come on up so he can close the service for us.
All right, let's give them one more hand. We should clap. Good job, everybody. All right, I'm gonna give them a second. I was reminiscing earlier in the first service, I was sitting beside my oldest, who's a little bit older now than the kids, and I was reminding him that both at the daycare concert and at the church concert, he decided to lift his shirt and show everybody his amazing chest. And he's like, I think I remember that. And I'm like, well, I know I remember it. So it's awesome. Even, you know what, kids, isn't it awesome just to watch our kids even lift their hands, sing, and especially just this time of year. You know, I just want to just end with just a real, real simple thought. Actually, I think it was Sarah and Sally Sheep pretty much said everything that I'm going to say, all right? But there's this moment that we see in Luke chapter 2, and it says where the angels showed up, and it says that there were shepherds living out in the fields, and they were watching their sheep, literally. And it says that these angels showed up and basically said just a couple simple things, and I just want to just remind all of us. It says that we've come to share, first of all, it said, don't be afraid, because I'm sure it was like a light that they had never seen in the middle of the night, and all of a sudden the angels show up, and they said, do not be terrified. And it says that we bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people tonight. A Savior, Christ the Lord, has been born. Now, we have the novelty that we can look back 2,000 years later and look at this and realize that people are still celebrating this very thing. That's what we're doing today. And all around the world, people are celebrating the arrival of Jesus. Now you got to realize, when this book was written, like when we read the accounts in Luke and Matthew, and we read, this is 2,000 years ago. And when I read it and I hear, this is going to be good news, it's going to be great joy, and it's going to be for all people. When this was written, it was actually after Jesus had been crucified and died. And I'm sure that lots of people thought the story of Jesus won't come to anything. But here we are 2,000 years later, and it is still good news, it's still great joy, and it's still for all people. Because why? A Savior has been born. And I just want to just hit that with all of you guys today, just to remind you, why is it good news that Jesus came? Well, first of all, it's a hope that goes beyond anything that we could face. Anything that you can encounter, it's good news. And why is it great joy? Well, you know what? Our world will try to tempt you with all sorts of temporary happiness. Get this, get that thing, do this, and you'll be happy. But the joy that we're talking about that comes with knowing Jesus and receiving Jesus is a joy that makes meaning even out of the most difficult things that we face in life, even our failures, even our greatest victories. They are all seen as meaningful and part of God's plan because of God's joy in us and his work in us. And I do love that it says it's to all people. Jesus has crossed every cultural land, border, everything, Jesus has gone around the world, and I believe that every culture and color has received, and they are following Jesus and have received the gift of Jesus. How could they have known 2,000 years ago that that actually would come true? So many great people, so many famous people, so many conquering people, you know, we don't even know their names anymore. But yet, this Jesus that came as a baby, and angels proclaimed his name will go across the world to every tribe and every nation, and we can actually say we've seen it to be true. God's word is true. And all of this just hinges finally on this thing, and he says, a Savior has been born. Now, all of us have a decision to make in life. And I really think it's just simply this. Do I need a Savior or don't I? And I think this guy does. See, he's with me. Thank you for your support. I see that hand. But you really do have to decide that, because Jesus comes again. It's Christmas time. And we've had this moment where Jesus is showing up, and we're reminding ourselves again and again. That's why we celebrate this every year, so it'll come back to mind that we realize that Jesus was given as a gift. But I have to receive that gift. And I want to encourage you that you would make a decision, okay? And this is as high pressure as it's going to get, okay? Just listen to me and hear me out. That you would receive the gift that Jesus is at Christmas. And you would even say, I need help. I need a Savior. I need to be made right. I want that great news, that good news. I want that great joy in my life. I want to even see that this is even for me. I'm some of those, all those people that God was talking about over 2,000 years ago, and that I would receive the gift that Jesus gives, his life for ours, forgiveness for sins. That's why we need a Savior. If I'm beyond admitting that I'm, you know, I've got some flawed areas and some broken areas and that I need a Savior, well, it's hard to receive the gift. But if you're right with us today and going, hey, you know what? I know I need a Savior. I want to encourage you, the best decision that you can make, even right now, even at this Christmas time, just say, Jesus, I receive you. So can I just pray for all of us? And you know what? I just want to just encourage you to do that and receive him at this time of year, okay? Let's all bow our heads. Lord, we just thank you for today. God, we thank you for the great songs, the great dramas, the dance, the everything, that God, that we can just proclaim you, Jesus, and speak and celebrate your arrival. And first of all, we just say, Jesus, thank you that you came. You came that we would have life, that it would be great news, it would be great joy, and God, it would be for everyone, no one excluded. No one's too far. No one's too broken. God, you can do your great work and redeem us and save us. And so, God, I pray that in this room, I don't know the position of everybody's life or their heart, but God, we just say we receive you today, Jesus. We say thank you that you came. And we say thank you that you came to save us. Save us from our brokenness. Save us from our sin. And so, God, we turn to you. And God, I just pray that this will be the absolute amazing Christmas we have ever had. God, that it would start a relationship with you. And so, God, we just welcome you into our lives. Just like the shepherds did, they ran out to meet you. And it says that they went out praising and celebrating who you are. And so, God, I pray over each one of us today that that would be the same attitude of our hearts, welcoming you in. And then running out and celebrating and praising you. And so, God, at this Christmas, let it be the most amazing Christmas yet. And I pray that over each one of us today. And I pray it in Jesus' name. And everyone said, amen and amen. All right, God bless you today. Merry Christmas. I want to just remind you, next week we'd love to have you come, either 3 or 5. And make sure, go get your picture taken. Go get some hot chocolate, hot cider. Take your kids outside with the animals. It's absolutely awesome. God bless you and Merry Christmas from us here at People's Church.
Hey, I hope you enjoyed today's message. We would love to hear your story and what God is doing in your life. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to email us, info@thepc.ca. At People's Church, we're here for you. We have something for everyone. You can check us out at thepc.ca or like us on Facebook. Have a great week, and thanks for joining us.